42-year-old Sandra Simard underwent back surgery under general anesthetic in 2007. 6 years later, she remains traumatized.
It was almost over. The surgeon was sewing it up, and then the heart stopped. So we had to resuscitate me for 82 minutes. And I was transferred to another hospital. I was in a coma for 5 days. So there are lesions in my brain which have affected my memory and concentration. Of course, I still have back problems, but I don't want to hear any more about surgery.
Today, she knows that it wasn't an accident. The bags used for her operation were supposedly poisoned. Dr. Frédéric Péchier, an anesthetist from Besançon, is the main suspect.
At no point are we going to imagine that it was a doctor who did this, because a doctor looks after and cares for his patient.
He's not here to hurt them.
And there would be many other victims. Dr. Péchier is now under investigation for 30 poisonings, 12 of them fatal. All took place in two clinics in Besançon. All during operations that are a priori risk-free for 10 years. Frédéric Péchier has maintained his innocence from day one. But the investigators are convinced that behind the brilliant doctor lies a man with a chilling profile who acted out of megalomania and a thirst for revenge.
There's a clear desire to harm his colleagues by attacking their patients.
Then there's his personality, his omnipotence, his desire to dominate everyone. It delights him to be the one called to help, to be the Zorro who's going to save people.
In the event of a conviction, we would be dealing with the second biggest serial killer in French legal history.
The case broke in 2017 at the Clinique Saint-Vincent, following Sandra Simard's cardiac arrest. At the time, cardiac incidents taking place during surgeries had been multiplying for years. Sandra's anesthetist, Dr. B, began to wonder. She tells the surgeon with whom she operated.
It's enough to make you paranoid. I'm sure someone is sabotaging our products.
Dr. B decides to conduct his own little investigation in the down low.
My anesthetist had gone to collect the equipment used during my surgery, the bags, syringes, everything she could find to have it analyzed, to see if there had been any pollution.
The results revealed that the saline bags had been poisoned with frightening doses of potassium, 100 times the lethal dose. The criminal investigation department was called in and discovered a strange atmosphere in the clinic. A doctor reportedly told a nurse,
"In the 30 years I've been pushing needles, there have never been so many cases. Someone's having fun."
The investigators decide to examine all cardiac accidents, known as serious adverse events. They identified 66 suspicious cases. The first case dates back to 2008. The victim was Amandine Yellen's father. Damien, an avid sportsman and lover of nature and animals, came to the clinic to have a kidney removed. But just as he had received the anesthesia, he died of cardiac arrest at the age of 53, before the surgery could even begin.
I spoke to him on the phone the day before, and he was a bit anxious, like anyone who's about to undergo surgery. I told him, "Don't worry, Dad, it's going to be fine. I'll see you tomorrow." I got a phone call in the morning on my dad's mobile. So when I picked up the phone, it was Dad. I picked it up and said, "Hello, Dad, are you all right?" And it turned out to be the anesthetist. It said, "This is the Clinique Saint-Vincent. There's been a problem. Your father has died."
An autopsy revealed the presence of an abnormal dose of lidocaine, a local anesthetic.
So it was with this report that we learned that lidocaine was present in my father's body with 5 times the lethal dose.
Dr. Péchier soon attracted the investigators' attention. Whenever there was an incident on the operating table, he was never far away, stepping in to help his colleagues. More often than not, he miraculously saves patients. From the outset of the investigation, the civil party's lawyers emphasized this strange coincidence.
We're amazed that he was able to make a diagnosis before anyone else.
While none of the professionals involved were able to make this diagnosis, and that he was therefore able to immediately carry out injections or procedures adapted to a situation that had not been diagnosed by anyone else. This is what attracted attention.
Out of 1,514 caregivers over the incriminated periods, there is a common denominator. It's not me saying it, it's the investigators. 1,514, a common denominator, Péchier. What do you want me to say?
Why would this doctor, considered one of the best in town, do this? What would have been the point of this person, apparently above suspicion? At 45, Dr. Péchier has succeeded in life. He lives in this large house in a wealthy and quiet village near Besançon. The son of an anesthetist, he has been married for 20 years to a cardiologist with whom he has had 3 children. An accomplished sportsman with a passion for golf and tennis, he is portrayed by many of his colleagues as an outstanding doctor, highly committed to his work. But other colleagues, both nurses and doctors, painted a very different picture of the anesthetist to the investigators.
He had an immeasurable ego.
His sin isn't modesty. He really needs to show off.
He thought he was the best, the indispensable doctor.
He needs a little extra adrenaline. This little thing of being needed to resuscitate, of being seen as the savior.
Is the anesthetist playing the pyromaniac fireman, poisoning patients in order to resuscitate them?
We've had several clients testify to me and tell me in procedure that Dr. Péchier went to see them afterwards to tell them, I saved your life. That's extraordinary.
In 2017, Dr. Péchier agreed to meet us in his lawyer's office. He denies all accusations.
I'm innocent. I didn't poison anyone. That's for sure. What would have been my interest? What would have been my motive? I didn't even know these people. I have a situation, I have a wife, I have a family, I have a fulfilling job. Why would I try to destroy all that with this pyromaniac theory?
It's not the little dose of adrenaline you can get, the feeling of omnipotence.
I don't need this omnipotent feeling. When I finish my day and everything has gone well, I go and see my patients and I'm happy.
Your colleagues have often been surprised that when you arrive to help out, you've already made a diagnosis or already know what to do.
I never made a diagnosis when I entered an operating room without knowing what was happening. With regard to the events I am accused of, I am never the doctor who makes the diagnosis. It's always one of my colleagues who makes the diagnosis first.
In the course of the investigation, the investigators discovered other highly disturbing coincidences. At the Clinique Saint-Vincent, every serious adverse event, SAE, was preceded by a conflict involving Dr. Péchier. Distribution of tasks or hiring of a new crew member. There were constant arguments with his colleagues.
We've noticed that when there's a conflict in the clinic, when there are periods of stress within the team, then the number of SAEs explodes. So there's a real correlation. We have 2 curves that follow each other in these periods, with an increase in SAEs. That's part of the motive.
Dr. Péchier's colleagues are finally convinced that he was getting revenge by attacking their patients.
He was doing it to get justice. You'd get into an argument with him. You'd have a cardiac arrest 3 weeks later.
He often changed targets depending on what was happening to him personally.
He was really aiming at anesthetists. The weapon was the patient.
A colleague, in fact, whom Dr. Péchier apparently wanted to retire a little early. This poor doctor has had three or four incidents in a very short amount of time when she had never had any in her career.
A couple of anesthetists, friends of Dr. Péchier, tell the investigators about another event. In February 2016, while dining with the Péchier, an argument broke out about the omnipresence of the anesthetist in the department. Tempers flared and the evening turned sour. The friends are not speaking anymore, and a little over a month after the clash, the wife enters the clinic to undergo shoulder surgery. At the last minute, she asked to be put to sleep by her partner. This changed the organization of the operating room. The operation goes well, but the patient who took her place, Lawrence Nicord, 50 years old, died after a cardiac arrest due to an overdose of local anesthetic. Again, there was no formal evidence against Frederick Péchier, but the investigators were convinced that the poisoned bags were intended for his former friend. For his lawyer, Maître Schwerdorfer, the motive of revenge is implausible.
It's not a soft environment, it's obvious. And Frederick Péchier is not denying it. But does that mean we're poisoning people?
As for Frederick Péchier, he denounces a conspiracy by his colleagues and an incriminating investigation.
I was particularly surprised by the comments made by three doctors and a recovery room nurse who, if you like, directed the police investigation directly at me. We had an initial hearing, which was exculpatory or neutral, and in the 24 hours that followed, these people spontaneously returned to the police station to conduct a hearing which, for me, was completely incriminating. And the recovery room nurse even named me as the person who was polluting the bags. I can't understand how anyone can change their mind in such a short amount of time. What happened? Were they put under pressure? I have no idea.
In addition to the statements made by his colleagues, the investigators believe that Dr. Péchier is particularly at fault. He is the only anesthetist never to have been the victim of a serious adverse event. Except once, on January 20th, 2017, the very day when the judicial police arrived on the premises to seize the first poison bags, those from the Simard case that broke the investigation wide open. That day, Jean-Claude Gandon, 70, enters the clinic to treat his prostate cancer.
The anesthetist was Mr. Péchier. I had a cardiac arrest and he had to give me three shocks to be able to come back. To life, as they say.
To save Jean-Claude's life, the surgery was interrupted. As the risk of inner bleeding was too great, it could never be rescheduled.
There are always places where we'd still be there. Because it didn't go all the way.
3 months later, Jean-Claude learns that he too has been poisoned. This time with local anesthetics injected into the paracetamol pouches. According to the courts, Frederick Péchier used this patient to forge an alibi.
We have 66 between 2008 and 2017. At the time, he was the only doctor and anesthetist who had never been the victim of an SAE. So he knows that all eyes will be on him. From then on, he had to have an alibi. That's what he's going to lose, because he's going to do it in a clumsy, disorganized way, because he's going to do it in a hurry.
Since his indictment, Frédéric Péchier has been placed under judicial supervision and forced to live far from Besançon, at his parents' home in the Vienne region. Weakened by his 6 years under investigation, he attempted suicide by defenestrating himself in September 2022, leaving behind a few words to his mother.
I want this life to end. I want to die innocent.
As I've always said in the Péchier case, for me, and I'm his lawyer, and I accept it, we're at the heart of a miscarriage of justice. All the energy of the investigators and the judicial system is focused on proving Frédéric Péchier's guilt. Talk about the Gandon case. How many times did we tell the examining magistrate? Find who's guilty. Stop assuming it's Péchier. If there's a trial, it won't be enough to make assumptions. We'll have to prove a man's guilt. It's easy to accuse someone. It's much harder to prove guilt.
Frédéric Péchier is still presumed innocent. The anesthetist could appear in court at the end of 2024, in a trial expected to last 2 months.